Students of class 7. So today I'm going to start the next the remaining questions of the exercise 7.4. So starting with question number 4, see what is given in question number 4. I'm thinking of a number. If 60 is subtracted from it, the result is 4. Find the number. So let the number be x. Okay, then let the number be x. Then what is given in question? That if we subtract 60 from it, then the result will be 4. So according to the condition, we can write x minus 60 is equal to 4. Okay. So x will be what? 4 plus 60, and the final answer will be 64. That means 64 is the number from which if we subtract 60, we will get 4. Okay. Next, come to question number 9. After buying a book, I am left with 5 rupees out of my 50 rupees note. So total rupees is rupees 50, okay, and the cost of book we have to find. So let the cost of the book be rupees x. So our linear equation, according to the given question, our linear equation will be x is subtracted from 50, so that the leftover, that means the remaining rupees left with him, will be rupees 5. Okay, so 50 minus x is equal to 5 will be the linear equation. So if you transpose 50 to that side, it will get subtracted. So minus x is equal to minus 45, and rest you know how to solve it. Already we have done this type of questions. So x is equal to 45. That means the cost of the book will be what? Rupees 45. So come to the next question number 10. If 10 is subtracted from thrice a number, that means we have to take the number as x. So thrice the number, that means 3 times of that number will be what? 3 into x, that is 3x. So according to the question, it is given, if 10 is subtracted from 3 times of that number, then we will get 35. So our equation will be 3x minus 10 is equal to 35. So rest, you know how to solve it, okay? So next is question number 11. It is given that if you add the 3 consecutive number, then the answer will be 36. So what is these 3 integers? So you have to write the, let the 3 consecutive here, write integers. Okay, integers. So let the 3 consecutive integers be x, x plus 1, x plus 2. So according to the question, we can write addition of the 3 numbers will be equal to what? 36. So 3x plus 3 will be what? 36. That means after solving, we will get 11. So what are these integers? What are these numbers? Yes, first number. So the first number will be 11. Then 11 plus 1 will be 11, 12. Then 11 plus 2 will be 13. Okay. So 11, 12, 13 are the 3 integers. So that the sum of these 3 integers will be what? Equal to 36. So see the next question, question number 12. So it is given that Sandeep has twice that of money Sonia has. Okay. So let Sonia has x rupees, therefore Sandeep has twice x, that means 2 into x rupees. Okay, because it is double of what? Sonia. Okay. So also one more thing is given, one most important thing, that if we add the 2 rupees, then we will get 150 rupees. Okay, so according to this condition, according to the question, we can write x plus 2x is equal to 150, therefore 3x will be equal to 150. That means x will be what? 150 by 3, and the answer is 50. So Sonia has 50 rupees, that means Sandeep has how much? Yes, twice into 50, that means 100 rupees. Okay, you can also check the answer by adding the 2 cost, that will be one is 50 and the other is 100. So you can add and you can easily find the answer. Next, come to question number 14. Let amount of money Ruchi had is equal to rupees x, therefore the amount of money Sindhu had is rupees twice x. So already it is given in question that Sindhu has twice that of money Ruchi had. Okay, so Ruchi had rupees x, so Sindhu had rupees twice x, that means you have to double that amount. One more thing is given that after buying their necessary, after doing shopping, okay, the money left with them are same, that is equal. Okay, so Ruchi shopped for utilities worth rupees 60. That means her expenditure is 60. So what will be the money left with Ruchi after shopping? Yes, you have to subtract 60 from the money that she had earlier. Okay, so x minus 60 is the amount of money Ruchi had. Next, money left with Sindhu will be how much? Yes, again you have to subtract the expenditure, that the expenses is rupees 210. So rupees 210 you have to subtract from 2x. Okay, now the leftover money, this money and this money will be what? Equal, because already it is given in question that you have to the amount, now both of them have the same amount of money left. That means you have to equate the two expressions, that is x minus 60 and 2x minus 210. Okay, so try to do this question. Next, you have to write like this. Okay, so x minus 60 is equal to 2x minus 210. So you have to transpose 2x to left hand side and minus 60 to that side to solve the equation, and finally you will get the value of x. That means the amount of money Ruchi had, you can easily get by solving this equation. And after solving, after finding the value of x, you can also find the value of 2x, that is the amount of money left with the amount of money Sindhu had earlier. Okay, that will be double of x. So the next question, question number 15. Already it is given that the length of a rectangular room is 3 more than twice its breadth. Okay, 3 more than means 3 is added to twice its breadth, means 2 times of its breadth. So first of all we have to take the breadth. Okay, so let the breadth of the rectangular room be x. So length will be how much? Yes, it is 3 is added to twice its breadth, that means 2x. So 3 plus 2x will be the length. So perimeter is also given. Perimeter is 66 meter. So we know that the perimeter of a rectangular room will be how much? Twice into length plus breadth. That will be equal to 66 meter. So in place of length, we can write 3 plus 2x, and in place of B, we can write x. So after solving, we got 2 into bracket 3 plus 3x is equal to 66. So remaining you have to do. Okay, so you know how to solve it. Okay, so try to solve this question. You can easily find the value of x, that will be our breadth, and after putting in the length, that is 3 plus 2x, the value of x you have to put in the place of x, then you can find the length of the rectangular room. So see the next question, student number 16. So here it is given in the question that Varun takes certain number of rotis during lunch but always waste half a roti. So let the number of rotis Varun take will be what? I have taken it 2x every day. Okay, so he consumed how much? 2x minus 1 by 2, because half of the roti, that means half of the roti he always waste. That means we have to subtract that half of the roti from the total rotis he took. Okay, so 2x minus 1 by 2, this much roti he consumed every day in lunch. And Rosa consumed how many? If they are taking these much of rotis, that is 2x minus 1 by 2 and x, if they are consuming this much of rotis every day, that means in 20 days we have to multiply 20 with this one, that is the total number of rotis Varun and Rosa consumed. Okay, we have to multiply it with 20. So it will be equal to how much? Yes, the total number of rotis they are taking together, so that will be what? 110. This is for how many days? 20 days. That's why I have multiplied here with 20. Okay, so next, see inside the bracket we have to solve, we have to collect the like terms, that is 2x plus x, that will be 3x minus 1 by 2. So after that just multiply this. So this will be 60x minus 2 into 1 by 2 will be 10, is equal to 110. So 60x is equal to 10, if you take to that side it will get added, so 120. So 60x is equal to 120, that means x will be what? 120 by 60, that will be 2. So 2, what was x? See, Rosa consumed x rotis every day, so that means this is the number of rotis consumed by Rosa every day. Okay, so next, How to find the number of rotis Varun take? Yes, 2 into x, that means 2 into 2, that will be 4. So how much roti Varun consume? That will be what? 2x minus 1 by 2. So 2x minus 1 by 2 will be what? 2x you can easily find. So 4 minus 1 by 2. By solving it, you will get what? That is 7 by 2. 7 by 2, you can write it as 3 1 by 2. So that means Varun consumed 3 1 by 2 rotis every day and he wasted, 3 1 by 2 rotis every day. Okay, and Rosa consumed 2 rotis every day. So how many rotis are wasted? You can easily find, already it is given that half of the roti is wasted every day. So in 20 days, how many rotis will be wasted? Yes, you have to multiply half with 20. Okay. So every day if you waste half of the roti, then in 20 days we can easily find half into 20, that will be what? 10. So 10 rotis is wasted in 20 days. Okay, students. So the next question is, see, already question is in your book, so I have written like this. See, let the number of chocolates Rahil had. So total, there is a total number of chocolates Rahil had. So some chocolates he has given to his brother and some chocolates to his friend, and the leftover chocolates is 30. Okay, so see, chocolates, let the number of chocolates Rahil had, suppose rupees, it is the quantity, so we have to write x. So chocolates given to his brother will be what? This is already written in the question that 1 by 3rd means 1 third of x. So 1 third of x means 1 by 3 of x. So that will be what? 1 by 3 into x, that is x by 3. And chocolates given to his friend will be what? 1 by 6 of x, that will be what? X by 6. So the leftover chocolate will be what? 30. Already it is given in the book. So now we have to find that how many chocolates Rahil has given to his brother and how many to his friends. So first of all, we will find the total number of chocolates Rahil had. Okay. So see, if we add the number of chocolate given to his brother, to his friend, and the leftover chocolates, that is x by 3 plus x by 6 plus 30, then we will get what? Then we will get the total number of chocolates. Okay. So the equation will be like that. According to this condition, we can write x by 3 plus x by 6 plus 30 is equal to what? X. Okay. So now just transpose x to left hand side and 30 to that side. So it will be minus on that side. So minus 30, and here you can write the LCM, that is 6. And finally, by simplifying the numerator, you will get minus 3x by 6 is equal to minus 30. So after simplification, the value of x is 60. That means the total number of chocolates Rahil had is 60. So the chocolates given to his brother will be what? This will be 60 by 3, because already it is given x by 3. So the chocolates given to his brother will be 20, and the chocolates given to his friend will be what? 60 by 6, that will be 10. Okay. So total number of chocolates is 60, and 20 number of chocolate is given to his brother and 10 number of chocolate is given to his friend. So 30 chocolates will be the remaining chocolates. Okay. So students, please try to do the questions and the remaining question which I have not done. Okay. And do the chapter checkup questions. Okay. So thank you.